Now we are at the last step of the design. Step number 9 is to design the transverse reinforcement. See, the footing will always bend transversely near the column face. So now we first have to find the moment which is acting for the column A, and next we have to find the moment which is acting at the column B. And later we will be finding the reinforcement which is provided for both the columns. So let us start from the column A. In the column A, we have to consider a cantilever projection which is acting beyond the face of the column. So now, for example, see, this is the plan of the footing. Here, this first column represents the column A. And the sizes of the column A are written as A and B. Here the size of A as well as B both are 300 mm. See, you can see the projection beyond this, the two faces of the column here. So these two projections are named as A1 and B1. Now we are finding the projections A1 and B1. To find this, we have to subtract the total width along with the width of the column, and we need to divide that with two parts. So on dividing the total width with the width of the column and by dividing it into two parts, we will be getting the individual size of the projection. That is what I have written here. That is A1 is equal to B1, which is equal to B minus B by 2, where capital B represents the width of the footing, which is 2000 mm. And small b represents the width of the column, which is 300. That divided by 2. On solving, you will get 850 mm. Similarly, we have to find the width of the bending strip here. To find that, we have to consider a critical section. Let us consider the critical section lying from the face of the column at a distance df. See, from the critical section, the face of the column as well as the end of the footing, both are acting at this equal distance df. These two distances are considered to be df here. And here, the bending strip is taken from the end of the footing to the end of the column A as B1. To find this B1, it will be found out by adding these two distances along with the width. Here the distance df plus df plus a gives you the total width b1. Now that is what it is written. Instead of a, I have written this as b, because a is equal to b here. Hence the formula to find b1 is written as b plus 2 times of df. 2 times of df, just because on adding df plus df, we will get 2 times of df. Now, you substitute the value of b and df here. Here, b represents the width of the column, which is 300. And df represents the depth of the flange, which is 310. On simplifying, you will get the value b1 as 920 mm. Now, let us find the net upward pressure, which is acting on the column A. To find that, the pressure is given by the formula load by area. Here the load what you have to consider should be the load which is acting on the column A, that divided by area. Here this much of area you have to consider. See, this much area, this portion area you have to consider, the shaded one you have to consider. So for finding this area, it is given by B into B1. So now, in the place of PA, you substitute the value of load which is carried by the column A, that is given in the question as 500 kN, divided by B into B1. Here, BE represents the width of the footing, which is 2 meter, that into B1. Just now we have found the value of B1 as 920 mm. You convert that in terms of meter by dividing the value with 1000. You will get 0.92 meter. Now, after substituting and later you simplify it, you will be getting the value of Q0 dash as 271.73 kN per meter square. Once the value of upward pressure is known to you, you find out the maximum bending moment which is occurring at the face of the column. To find that, see, this is the for this portion we have to consider the maximum bending moment. That means we have to find the maximum bending moment for the cantilever projection of the column. And we know that the maximum bending moment formula for the cantilever is given by WL square by 2. Here, W represents the load which is coming over the column A, and that is in the form of the net upward pressure, which is Q naught dash, that into L. Here L represents the length of the projection. So those two lengths are given by A1 and A2. As we are squaring the length, we are having the two different lengths here. One is A1, other is B1. So you write this as A1 B1 divided by 2. The value, you know the value of Q01, that is 271.73. You know the value of A1 and B1, both the values are 850 mm. You convert that in terms of meter by dividing the value with 1000. You will get 0.85 as both the values, whole divided by 2. On simplifying, you will be getting the value of your mass 98.16 kilonewton meter. Now you just convert this in terms of factored load, factored moment, for which you multiply the value with factor of safety 1.5. On multiplying, you will be getting the moment of 147.24 kilonewton meter.